I'm Janae, this is Davis, that's Nick, and that's Danny. We're doing Everybody's a Critic, and today we're going to be talking about The Revenant. Danny, did you like The Revenant?
I love The Revenant. The Revenant is a really great movie. It takes place in the early 1800s. It's about a man named Hugh Glass, played by Leonardo DiCaprio, who is a fur trapper, who has an awkward encounter with a bear and ends up seriously injured. So it's kind of like a brief summary. Let's take a look at it, and then we'll talk about it.
Awkward encounter with the bear?
Yeah, I said awkward encounter
with
the bear.
Is it because, are you talking about the part where everyone thinks the bear humps him? Is that where you're
talking
about?
No, That, I remember reading about that, how people, like, there were rumors that
thought
the
he
bear,
got raped by
like,
the bear.
Yeah, the bear, you know, like, assaulted like,
touches
him.
Touches him, yeah.
Yeah, no, that's not what happened in the movie, but I thought The Revenant was, I mean, they would go to set and, like, the place they wanted to shoot would be underwater one day and they had to come back weeks later, but it just, I think that using the natural light just makes, it kind of provides like this blue, really cold lighting to everything that really sort of amplifies like the harsh atmosphere of the movie. And the movie is like drenched in atmosphere. Like everything from just, they use a lot of wide lenses to shoot even like close-ups and big environmental shots, and everything just feels massive and like overwhelming. And even the close shots of the character, like you can see them breathing on the camera. And you feel like small. I found myself curled into a ball, like sitting in the theater and wishing that I was like wearing another layer.
I'm kind of just imagining like a Pokeball, like fully.
I was like curled with my arms wrapped around my knees in the theater, and I loved it. Like that sounds miserable, right?
But it's
great. Yeah.
I will say that's talking about natural lighting. What I found impressive about that is the way Lubezki, like, bent the natural light to make it work for him. Like you see, like even when they're inside, they're sitting by a window to let the natural light in there, and that's how they use. And they use reflectors and diffusers, of course, to kind of work off that. But it's still, and then when they're in the bar scene, they use natural oil light. And, you know, like they're constantly just finding ways to make natural light work. And I'm sure it's been done before, but something about it was just really pretty and organic, you know. And of course, it's not literally they just go out there and shoot. You know, they use techniques, but it's still. And you talked about the breathing on the camera. That was one of my favorite parts when, that's all I can say.
I'll be honest.
There's two parts I disliked about the movie. I will admit.
Oh.
And they're not like I dislike because they're bad. It's when, spoiler, I guess, because this is a real shock factor. When Hugh Glass goes to drink the water, it comes out his throat.
I was not ready for that.
I was like, okay, I think I'm dunning my Twizzlers.
So that was a criticism
disgusting.
Of the movie?
Well, it's like, you grossed me out a little bit too much there. Like, I think Rolling Stones said in the review, like, the first sentence is, this movie's not for pussies. Like, movie really fits a very niched amount of audience. Like, there's going to be people who would walk out just by being grossed out by it.
Mm-hmm. Like, it's a very brutal movie.
The fact that Leonardo DiCaprio is a vegetarian and he eats raw liver on set. And, like, his gag was the first shot and they just kept it in there. Like, yeah, it's gross, isn't it? See, that's what I'm saying. Like, it's really gross. Like, not everyone's going to get that gross. And the other problem I had, and it wasn't necessarily a problem I had, but both, I went to see my family. My dad and my sister had the same complaint. They couldn't understand Tom Hardy in the beginning. Because he talks like this, you know, he's like, oh, God.
Yeah, because I felt like they never said it, but I was like, this character is going to freeze to death, and so he's literally just climbing into a horse. Like, I never saw the actor
That's my problem with. And that's why, you know, everyone talks about it. Leo's never won an Oscar. He's never won an Oscar. Why does he win an Oscar? And you have two. There's another person I think. But what I'm trying to say is Leo, I always see Leonardo DiCaprio. In whatever role he is, I always see him. I'm like, oh, Leo's doing a great job right now. Like, I saw Paul Fitzgerald. I saw Fitzgerald when I saw Tom Hardy. I didn't see Tom Hardy. Even Donald Gleason's character, I saw him as the captain. I didn't see him. You know, they really absorbed. Leonardo DiCaprio's like, man, I can't believe Leonardo DiCaprio's cutting open doors. That's how. And I would say it's just so interesting. I guess some people can take themselves out of it, but in that same vein, the movie had another problem with Lubezki, the cinematographer. I was like, wow, look at this shot he's doing. Like, but I feel like that's also the movie is, wow, look at what they've done, and that added a dimension. It's another reason why I love it is look what these guys just went through to get this shot.
Yeah.
Like, it magnified the intenseness of the movie to think what they were doing.
So to you, that's a good thing.
Right? Yeah, to like, me, it was like a good thing. Like, it heightened thinking, the performance.
Because I've seen a lot of people saying that the cinematography, like, I mean, it's obviously a technical marvel, but that it distracted them from the movie, right? Because, like, that was my issue with Birdman last year was, you know, yeah, wow, it looks great. Everything is done super perfectly. But the whole one-take gimmick is, like, a little excessive because I was constantly like, oh, the camera's here and now it's over here. Like, how did they get that shot? I didn't feel like that at all in The Revenant, you know? I think you can sort of see the inspiration from, or like the mannerisms from Birdman in these long takes, but it moves supernaturally. It's never excessively flashy, I felt. I felt like every movement of the camera was really natural and had a purpose rather than just being like, we did our whole movie in one take, but there are still critics who will say that now the gimmick isn't just we did it all in one take, and I see Janae giving me like you know, salty looks over there, but the gimmick now isn't like we did it all in one take, but it's look at how hard it was to make this movie, like, oh man, you know, our set was underwater, oh, give us the Oscar. Like, what do you guys think about, I mean, I disagree with that, but what do you guys think about that?
Yeah, I mean, for me, like, the artistic process is almost as much part of the art as, you know, the actual movie itself. Mm-hmm. And like, reading about this movie, I almost question like who really went through more, like Hugh Glass or Inarritu.
One other thing I have to mention here, because again, this is something that's been brought up a lot of times and no one's really thought about it a lot. Did when the Native Americans are talking sometimes, did it feel like their words weren't matching their mouths? Did anyone feel like that?
I never noticed the words.
That. I have read that.
I've read it a couple times and I kind of noticed it.
Maybe on a second viewing I would pay attention to that, but I didn't notice it at all.
See, I have to read
the words, so I can't like look.
Yeah,
at
the subtitles kind of maybe distracted from it.
I see. Part of me feels like I don't know the language, so like I feel like the language just didn't require them to move their mouths as much, so it seems like it's not matching. I don't know.
Also, just like with the way they do a lot of sound in movies these days, a lot of it is recorded in post.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
you know, especially with the way they've shot this movie, you know, they probably had a very hard time getting the audio while they were getting all those shots and, you know, only being able to shoot for an hour or two a day and shoot a scene. So, I mean, if that's, like, the one thing that is kind of missing or falling is the Indians' voices not matching up, I feel like that's kind of a small criticism.
Small complaint, yeah.
One thing I feel like we have to do justice real quick, just get your guys' opinions on it, the makeup designs. Like, the chapped lips on Hugh Glass.
My lips are chapped.
They
the scalp on Tom. I mean, it was just... It was so believable. Like, it literally, I was like, DiCaprio, did he not wear chapstick for like 2 years for this? Like, that's how legitimate it looked. It was,
I was like, I mean, I'm not squeamish, but, you know, there's a lot of horrible, gruesome violence in this movie, right? Like, after the scene where Leo gets mauled by the bear, which we'll talk about, I'm sure.
Yeah.
You know, you get this shot of him on his back and you see, like, the damage that the bear did, and it is. It's like shocking. It's really, really brutal, you know. And I remember, like, it was super impressive. You know, I don't know if it's nominated for any of like the makeup or costumes.
Yeah, I mean,
but
Janae's
got all her my papers.
I know
we
got all over the table.
It did get makeup and hairstyling. Yeah,
makeup and hairstyling. I think it should definitely win that, especially because Tom Hardy's half of his head scalped off hairstyle was gorgeous.
That was so ugly.
I'm thinking about taking on that look. About Tom Hardy's character, though. You know, Janae was saying that he is so, like, evil and
it's
terrible.
Amazing.
Like, I watched this review last night about The Revenant, and it kind of made me question, like, is he super evil? Because think about it. Tom Hardy is, like, this character who doesn't have time for sympathy in this world that has shown him none, right? And so he sees Leonardo DiCaprio, and it's this one guy, or Hugh Glass, excuse me, this one guy who, you know, any reasonable person would think that he's going to die after being mauled by a bear. And, you know, they're sacrificing time and money and possibly lives to carry him up the mountain or whatever. You know, was it a super... I mean, he does pull the evil trick where he's like,
The blinking part was so intense. I was like, how do you not blink? And then you're watching, and you're like, I can't blink if he can't
blink.
But
I don't know if he's as evil as... I think he's definitely unlikable. But I don't know if he's as evil as people are making it out to be. I think he's just kind of hardened, and it's just a matter of, I need to survive.
I thought that was one of the best parts about his character, was that he's definitely... You hate him in the movie. The movie's definitely framed for you to be very disdainful for him. He kills your main characters essentially.
Yeah.
But if you really like put yourself in his shoes and you listen to like what he has to say and where he's coming from, if I was where he was, I can't necessarily say I would do anything different. He is very explained, but I hope I wouldn't kill the kid. That was probably where the line would be drawn between like evil and bad. But for the most part, a lot of his motivations are very well shown. You see where he's coming from.
But he's greedy.
I think his character is like contrasted with Domhnall Gleeson's, because like they're both like hard and they've been going through the same things. But then he's like, we have to save Hugh, and he's like, just kill him. So I think it's very like stark good and evil, but then like of course it gets blurred because it's a movie. That's how it works. But I think that contrast really just made him look even worse.
Well, it's like the best villains, like Nurse Ratched in One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, like greatest villain of all time. She's not completely evil. She's just trying to get these people well. You know, sure, her methods are distinct.
Well, she's
evil, don't get me wrong, but Fitzgerald is, I mean, he's greedy. He killed someone for and he lied. He lies to,
for money.
He lies and goes, Indians are coming. The Indians are coming. We gotta go. And then he's like, no, man, I totally lied about that. They weren't even close, you know? And he's ruthless. But again, that's the best kind of villains. You gotta question, what about their motives? Like, that's one of the best parts about Tom Hardy's character. That's why he's such a good performance. That character makes you believe, why am I not right? You know, he does that very well throughout the film, I feel like.
How do you mean? Like, why am
I
not right?
Well, there's the monologue with the squirrel when he's like, I saw God. You know, and when they're fighting, he's trying to, like, he's even when he's facing death, he's still trying to justify his actions. He doesn't think he's wrong. He's like, it's kill or be killed here. I'm not in the wrong, am I?
Do the ends justify the means?
Well,
he ends up dead at the bottom of a river.
What I'm saying is, like, he has his own justifies, and that's what makes a villain good, is when they don't see the error in their ways. He didn't think he was wrong.
So he's like super true evil. That's what you're trying to say.
Yeah, there's a twistedness in there.
Well, let's bring it to the bear scene, because I feel like that's the big one that we haven't talked about, right? Everyone's talking about the bear scene. Jonah Hill goes dressed up as the bear on the Golden Globe stage. I don't want to say it was the highlight of the movie, but it was definitely the one that, like, the scene in the movie that I remembered most walking out, right? You know, this movie's full of really layered, complex shots with a lot going on visually, which I think is just sort of Iñárritu sort of showing his master of the craft, right? Like, all these super complex things with people moving between trees and weaving around. But, like, I do not understand how they did the scene with the bear. I'm sure some of it was CG, but it was super convincing. I was just totally blown away by it. It's so, and no cuts, too, which I love, you know? Love that a lot of action movies, not that this is an action movie, but we'll do this thing where it's all about, like, shaky cam, and then just quick cuts from different angles, and it's confusing, and you're supposed to tell from the sound that something terrible is going on. But this movie, and I think it's especially shown in the scene with the bear, is not afraid to show you anything. Because it's just constant wide shot, one take, moving with what's going on, and it's brutal and, like, but morbidly, like, you have a morbid curiosity. Like, I was like, oh my God, but I don't want to stop looking at it. Like, is he going to be okay?
Mid-peak.
Yeah, it was extremely intense and exceptionally well shot.
I'll say, from my standpoint, walking out of the theater, it wasn't my favorite scene. It wasn't. I liked the opening, the ambush by the Indian scene, where it's tracking, following people as they die. He dies to follow the guy who killed him kind of thing. I liked that walking out. Then I read an article in the New York Times about how they did the sound effects for the bear. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you guys know this, but so most of when the bear's like with its cubs and stuff making those noises, that was actual bear noises.
Yeah.
That was. When it's mauling him, they said you can't get close to a bear mauling people and record that. So they couldn't actually make that sound. So what they used was an agitated horse, and they combined it with the bear growls to make that kind of angriness. And then when he drools, they used a camel.
What?
Yeah. So they combined, like, aggravated aggravated horse breasts with calm bear breasts and like slowly mixed them in to make it sound like
sound
it was a
sound
bear.
Mixing, yeah.
Sound mixing.
Sound mixing.
Sound mixing. Right,
is he nominated? Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
Camel, bear. Yeah.
And I was like, just newfound respect for it after that. I was like, damn.
That
all
was
right.
Impressive, yeah.
Was anyone else just groaning when you see the bear turn around and he starts coming back?
And then he had the gun and I was like, just don't do it. And then he came back and I was like, I can't believe round two.
The gun was actually, me and my friends had a debate when we walked out of the movie about why did he shoot the bear.
I feel like it was leaving.
Like,
I was like,
you know, my friend thought that the bear just would have walked away. And at first, I disagreed with him. I thought, you know, if anybody knows more about how to fight a bear, it's probably Hugh Glass. I mean, he knows what he's doing. But like when I saw it for the second time, I really thought that was kind of setting up this sort of vengeful nature in Hugh Glass. It was kind of a foreshadowing. He got mauled by this bear. He was going to get his licks in too.
That's an interesting way to look at it, yeah.
Well, before I watched the movie, I read this article, and it was totally misogynistic, and it was like, ladies, sit this movie out. It's super graphic. And I, of course, responded, and I was like, it's a CGI bear. Relax. I can handle it. And then I watched the movie, and I was like, well, actually, that's a little intense. I mean, women can still handle it, but that was...
It is very
It intense. Was intense. I was like, is this what it's like to be mauled by a bear? Because, like, the long shot, and I was like, this is, like, it seemed so real. And then when it kept coming back, I was like...
Yeah, and I mentioned that's it kept coming back. Like, you see the preview for it, and you know there's a bear attack in the movie. Like, we all knew the bear attack was in there, and it kind of grabbed you. And you're like, okay, that's the bear attack. And you're like, oh, okay, it's coming back.
Yeah.
Okay, well now, so, oh no, it's coming back again. Like, it was such a long period of time. You're just like, God, is this bear done yet? Like, holy cow, it's like mauling the crap out. I mean, like, is it done yet in a bad way? I'm like, I can't believe this bear is still beating the crap out of him.
It goes on forever.
It's
painful.
And of course, then when he finally kills the bear, he can't even get away from it because it falls right on top of his body and he's trapped.
Yeah. Well, is that it? Anyone else? Anything else about the movie?
I mean, let's talk about last thing. Like, who would you recommend this movie to? Because, you know, I think this is one of the best movies of the year, but I definitely would not recommend it to some people. Like, my grandma was in town when we saw this movie and she came with us. She's very opposed to violent movies and stuff like that, and I just hear her the whole time, like, oh no, like gasping to herself. I wouldn't recommend this movie to the faint of heart. You know, it's very graphic. It's very long. I don't think it's overlong, but if you're not, Janae thinks it's too long. But if you don't want to sit down for a 2.5 hour movie that maybe feels like 3.5 hours, don't go see this movie. It's definitely a heavy experience. You're not going to be having fun. It's not a popcorn movie. Thoughts?
I suppose. I mean, you cover it. I'm not going to let my grandparents see that movie. You know, that's pretty obvious. But to me, I tell people, like, it's long, but every frame of that's a painting. I know that's... Yeah, sorry. I just realized I said that. I just realized it. But it really is, like, every scene has a purpose in this movie to me. Like, there wasn't a wasted scene. And Janae would probably disagree with me, I'm sure.
No, yeah, I will.
Yeah. So, but, I mean, overall, like, rating-wise, I give it a 9.6 out of 10. That's how good
I would give this one a 10. I would give it a perfect score.
Yeah, I'm with the 10 too.
Oh my God, I'll give it like a 9.0.
Because
I'm feeling generous. We talked through it. I'm feeling.
What would you have given it before we talked through it?
Probably like an 8.8.
Oh, okay. Okay.
we got a 0.2, you guys.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Well, this has been Everyone's a Critic Extended. We were just talking about The Revenant. Thank you guys for watching. Go see it before it leaves theaters. You want to see it on a big screen.
Huge.